as well hear what he has to say.
Don't go making me throw you back in there now, eh?
Well? So, what'll it be? Last you a good while. Not bad, if I do say so myself. It lasts you a good while. Best work, but it'll do. You can thank me later. Anything else? Make it quick. But I ain't the cook, am I? Look. You got anything needs repairing? Finally crawled out of the crypt, eh? You look like it. Although I thank you for doing us the courtesy of covering up.
Don't.
Oh, still have a bit of fight left in you? Then listen. I've arranged a meeting with Gav. In case you've forgotten, you're the one he's been putting his nose to work for.
For nothing.
Just listen. While you've been relaxing in your cell, Gav's been busy sniffing out your dominance. And according to his last report, he's picked up a scent. Gav's gone to a fair bit of trouble for you. The least you can do is hear the poor bugger out. He's going to meet us at the King's Fall. Pack your stuff. We'll leave as soon as you're ready. Come on. Gav will be waiting for us. Get your stuff together.
And what do you want? Coin purse weighing you down? It'd better all be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. I reckon I can find a buyer. I'll be thankful you got that much. Is that all?
Someone shat in your shoes. Well, whatever's wrong with you, keep your chin up, eh? Stops you drowning.
If you can read, don't let Otto know. We'll put you to work on the ledgers too.
Never knew dung had so many uses.
And how might this old soul be of service? I don't believe you've read this particular chapter before. I have quite the find for you today. If you have a question for me, I should be happy to answer it. You are always welcome, Clive.
It's nice to see the hideaway finally coming alive. Wasn't so long ago us old hands were rattling about the place like peas in a bucket.
Here you, newcomer. Why don't you join me for a drink, hmm?
Odin and Bahama had at it by all accounts. Not by Belinus Tor.
Gods, it's a wonder we didn't feel it here.
Is that book interesting?
You'd know if you learned your letters.
Back on your feet, are you? Make sure you stay that way. I've enough to worry about without you deciding to do yourself a mischief.
I thought I had escaped them. The royal army may be at our gates ere long.
The line didn't work.
Back to work, I suppose.
I'll have to try something else.
you see the girl Sid brought back with her?
What are you doing out of the dungeon? I mean, so long as Sid's all right with it. What are you doing out of the dungeon? I mean...
Fancy a mug of Kenneth's coldest when we're done?
This tight as shit, pal.
Clive, wasn't it? I heard you got locked up. Ah, don't look so down. Happens to the best of us. Well, us who are halfway interesting anyhow.
Come on. Gav will be waiting for us. Get your stuff together.
The girl you came with is still sleeping. Don't disturb her, please.
What's this? Thirds is.
Not so long ago, this here was a thriving trade route. Then the blight came. The people left. And just like that, it was deserted. Making it the perfect little shortcut. Gab's waiting for us up ahead. Come on. Still feeling sorry for yourself?
Please.
Think about it, Clive. The rumours all point to... That was an Imperial signal. They shouldn't be here. The old fort's been abandoned for years. Our little chat can wait. I need to see what the bastards are up to. You go on ahead and meet up with Gav.
But we both know that...
No buts about it.
This is stupid. I'm the dominant of fire. We sent Gav on a wild goose chase.
Over. You lose.
Perfect little shortcut, Sid. Straight to a nest of bloodthirsty beasts. Can't be much further now.
Sick of Torgal!
Over here. Yeah!
Is it, boy?
After him! Don't let him escape! Gaff! Who goes there? This one's a deserter! Take his head!
Out of my way!
You made your choice!
That's enough.
Escape! kill the deserter!
Clive, what's the situation?
You're late. Gav's in trouble.
What?
The Imperials are on his tail. We have to get to him before they do.
Understood. I'm here to even the odds. Any objections? I'll take the dragon. You take the dragoon.
Keep your distance, boy. Not this time.
Die, you bastard!
I think that hurt me more than it hurt him. Sorry, lad. Don't know how much help I'm gonna be here. All right. One down, one to go.
When could these bastards fly? The war goes up, must come down.
Bloody time waster. Come on, let's finish him off. Come on.
Shit!
me, Clive!
I've got you.
Clive doesn't have your nose, I said. He'd stumble off a cliff, I said.
That's the trouble with a nose like mine. Can't help sticking it where it's not wanted. But if it wasn't for you two, my sniffing days would be over. Thank you. Truly.
So, what news?
Well, found out where your friend's heading, for one thing.
Gav, I...
Him and his mate are on their way to your old stomping ground, Rosaria. You should have seen what they did to the Imperials who tried to stop them. There's no question about it. He's a dominant of fire, all right.
He can't be.
Clive, I saw you turn into an icon before my very eyes. And yes, there's a good chance it was you who killed the Phoenix. But we weren't alone, were we? There was the fellow you saw enter the whirlwind. I saw him too. You didn't dream it, Clive. He's out there.
But who is he?
Don't ask me. I don't bloody know. But I do know one thing. You're gonna find him and find out. After all, you swore an oath.
What?
You swore you'd avenge your brother's death, that you'd never rest until you'd hunted down the man responsible. So, find out if this man's responsible and kill yourself if he's not.
Sid, I...
Don't thank me. Thank Gav.
Thank you, Gav.
Yeah, there you are.
No birds returning this year.
The deadlands have swallowed their roosts, like as not. We're running out of time.
We'll be in Rosaria in a day or two.
Back to where it all began. He must be stopped.
Spitting great gouts of fire he was, like a bleeding volcano.
Ever seen a volcano?
What? You think I'm having you on?
Clive! Your friend! She's awake!
Right.
Go to her, you fool. Right, you lot. Enough slacking. Goots, come with me. Gav, go and get those wounds seen to.
Oh, give it to me straight. How long have I got?
So?
All in good time. Let's make ourselves scarce.
Jill.
Isn't the Moogle funny?
I wonder what it's trying to say.
They even have a Moogle. I've never seen one in the flesh. I'm sure it said in my father's bestiary that they live deep in the forest, and that they never reveal themselves to humans. Nectar, you say? Clive. So it would seem. That sounds painful.
Let's get this fixed before someone does themselves a mischief.
It's true then. It really is you.
It is.
Life.
So are you. I still can't believe it. Are your wounds healed?
Yes. Taya told me what happened. You saved my life.
After nearly taking it, I had no idea. Forgive me, but how did you ever come to be there, Jill? Fighting for them.
The Iron Blood. They invaded not long after the news arrived about Phoenix Gate. Rosaria had lost her leaders. The duchy was in chaos. The Iron Kingdom saw our weakness and pounced upon it. They killed the men and captured the women.
And took you back to Ironholm.
I thought they meant to have their fun with me before the end. But the end never came. My powers awoke, and everything changed. It all happened so fast.
We were told that the Ironblood had captured a Dominant and planned to bring her on their latest crusade.
They gave me a choice. To fight for them on the battlefield or see my countrywomen slaughtered.
And they call us Dominants.
What? What happened to Clive? What happened at Phoenix Gate?
It was me. I killed Joshua.
No, that's not true. I know you. You wouldn't do that.
It's the truth. I changed into him again, not long ago. The second Icon of Fire. The one responsible.
Clive.
When I think back to that night... The hooded man, he spoke to me. What did he say?
Swansea.
We have found you. What did he mean?
Clive, we should go back there, to Phoenix Gate. I need to know what really happened, and so do you. You need to know for certain. And if what you told me is true, and you did what you said you did, then we will face it together.
Jill, I... All right.
You'll be needing a change of clothes, then.
Out you go, your lordship. We wouldn't want you getting overexcited.
Sorry.
I'll see you soon, then, Clive.
I should be ready, too. We've a long journey ahead of us.
I thought I told you to make yourself scarce. Your friend needs to get dressed.
Let's get this fixed before someone does it.
We're looking at half a dozen.
What do you want?
To say farewell. We're leaving.
Good decision. Better that than buried out there in the black. You've got a lot to thank that girl for, you know.
I know. And I will.
Now, what do you really want? We both know you don't come here for conversation. It'd better all be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. Off you go, then. And best of luck.
I should probably say thank you to Gav, too.
I'm sure I'll be calling on your help again, if you've a mind to lend it. A carpenter's work is never done around here.
I see I'm busy here. What do you want? No scratches, all right? Best work, but it'll do. No scratches, right? Anything else?
I trust you're settling in?
Gradually getting used to the place.
I'm glad to hear it. I was hoping you might be persuaded to come to my aid once more. Your services will be rewarded, of course.
I don't doubt it. Seems to be the way around here.
We strive to be better than those we once served. Now, as to the task itself, I am once again in need of a pair of hands to deliver sustenance to our esteemed companions. I have three meals for three industrious souls. What say you?
I'd be happy to help.
Marvelous. The three individuals you'll be seeking out are busying themselves about the hideaway. You'll find one by the entrance, another in the bunks, and the other guarding the cells. Thank you once again, Clive.
Just don't have enough teams to follow every lead.
No, not even if they were teams of one.
Isn't the Moogle funny?
You, newcomer, I need help.
What's the matter?
It's my assistant. She left to gather soil. And I've seen nothing of her since. I cannot concentrate one whit for fear of what might have happened. Please, I beg of you, will you go and check? I have to know.
All right, I'll go.
Marvelous. Thank you. You'll be rewarded for your time, of course.
Whereabouts is she?
Gotan's Bales. It's on the outskirts of Lostwig. Not the safest place for an unaccompanied bearer, perhaps, but the soil there is second to none. Now go, and do not linger. Why, it may already be too late.
Oh, what I wouldn't give for some wild Mickey berries.
Can I help you?
Kenneth sent me.
Ah, wonderful. Do you hear that? Our food has arrived. Does your appetite still elude you?
Is he sick?
I'm afraid so. Those no longer in need of a physica's immediate ministrations are sent here for further rest. I tend to those who cannot tend to themselves, which leaves me very little time for anything else. Happily, Kenneth sees that I stay fed. I would be lost without the kindness of good people like him and yourself. Thank you. Come, you must eat if you're to recover.
Ah, glad to see the color back in your cheeks. That's one less thing to worry about.
Thank you.
two with a proper place to train.
Something smells good. For me, I hope.
It is. Courtesy of Kenneth.
Oh, my thanks. These birds are needy creatures. They don't like me running after the fat chocobo behind their backs.
They must keep you busy.
Ah, there's never a moment's rest. Probably for the best I eat down here, reeking of the stables as I do. I'd only put people off their food. And who has time to wash and dress for dinner when they've got little darlings like these to wait upon, eh? Anyway, thanks for the food, and be sure to give Kenneth my regards.
So soon? Fancied another kip in the cells, did you?
Kenneth sent me. He thought you might be hungry.
He wasn't wrong. The way my gut's been growling, I'd have curls running scared.
Guard duty down here can't be much fun.
It's not. But sometimes folk need locking up, and someone has to watch over them. I help people sleep at night, and that's not a boast many can make. You keep yourself on the right side of these bars now, you hear me?
I think that's everyone. I better let Kenneth know.
We're looking at half a dozen.
Ah, you're back. All done? Here, your reward, as promised.
The hideaway is quite something. Everyone has their place.
A fact we are proud of, believe me. I'm glad you've witnessed it for yourself. You have your place too, of course, as you have just so capably proven, and you will always have a place with us, should you desire it.
It's kind of you to say so.
It is the truth, and not a soul among us would deny it. I look forward to all that you will bring to our little community.
So your mind's made up, is it?
We'll be leaving for Rosaria as soon as we're able.
Back down memory lane, eh? Rosaria ain't what she used to be, Clive. Not since the Imperials moved in. First sign of trouble, you make straight for Martha's Rest and ask for the landlady. She's a friend of the cause. Tell her you're with Sid, and she'll help you out.
Understood. Thank you, Gav. Yeah. I'd be lost without you.
Yeah, I'm just doing my job. No need to make such a fuss. You take care, all right? Oh, I'm crap at goodbyes. Where's Sid when you need him?
Give him my regards when he gets back.
I will.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Ready, my lady?
ready.